guys are doing, I'm Anime Intensity, and welcome back to my channel. Today we're actually having another day filled with anime news, which I haven't done in a while. I apologize if I haven't made an anime news because, you know, news has been kind of slow. Like, there's been some big announcements, I've made some videos on those particular announcements before, but there wasn't enough material, so that's why anime news kind of took a little break. I know these months get a little quiet, and that's usually what happens every year, so I apologize for not making anime news in the past few weeks, but we're having another one today because there's a lot of things to talk about, and I hope you guys enjoy this week's anime news. I usually never know where to start, but I usually start with something that just caught my eye for the week, something that I'm like, whoa, this is interesting, this is bizarre, this is weird, this is cool, something that just really caught my eye, and this week it was the Detective Pikachu trailer, and that's why I decided to wear this shirt. I actually just filmed a reaction video to the trailer as well, so if you haven't seen that video, definitely go check that out if you like reaction videos. But honestly, I don't know how many of you have seen the Detective Pikachu trailer. I think the majority of people have seen it already. The trailer actually just debuted on Monday, and I gotta admit, it was actually really cute. I really liked it. I was scared at first for this movie when I heard the announcement. I was like, okay, this is going to be a disaster, and I think a lot of people actually had the same thoughts, but now seeing the trailer and seeing, wow, they actually put a lot of effort into this, like they put like over 60 Pokemon in the trailer itself, like it looks like they've really put a lot of thought into the trailer, so I'm like, okay, maybe this could go somewhere, so I'm actually kind of hopeful, and I want to go see it now. And that movie is actually going to be released in May 2019 for those of you who want to go see this film. But honestly, that trailer exceeded my expectations, and I'm cool with that. Okay, so let's now go to the real news, the actual news. A lot of anime announcements this week, so maybe your favorite series is getting an anime adaptation or a reboot, something like that, or a third season. So let's see. So the first anime announcement is actually for Fire Force. Fire Force is by Atsushi Akubo, who is responsible for Soul Eater and Soul Eater Not. I don't know how many of you loved or watched Soul Eater. It's one of my favorite series in terms of the manga. I love the manga for Soul Eater. Loving that manga made me want to read Fire Force, and Fire Force is really, really awesome as well. I'm not caught up with Fire Force, but it's being published by Viz, so if you would like to check out that manga, definitely do. It's getting an anime in 2019, and the studio that's actually going to be working on it is David's Productions, which actually worked on JoJo's Bizarre Adventure and Cells at Work. So if you liked either of those anime, you know what they can do. They can make good anime. So I'm actually really looking forward to the Fire Force anime. There are currently 14 volumes released in Japan, with the 15th volume being released in about like 2 days. So it's really awesome to know that it's getting an anime adaptation. It's really interesting. The story is really different. Like, people are being possessed by demons. They end up like spontaneous combusting. It's really interesting. And then you have these people that are fighting against these demon-possessed people. So it's a really interesting take on like firefighting, and it's something that I think you guys should check out, especially since the anime is going to be made by Davis Production. I think that they can make it into a really beautiful anime production. I think it's going to look great, I think it's going to be animated great, and I think it's just going to be, I think it's going to be fire. I'll escort myself out now. Moving along to the next big anime announcement, it turns out that Fruits Baskets will actually be getting another anime. So if you have read Fruits Baskets before or watched the 2001 anime adaptation, Fruits Baskets will be getting a reboot. So Fruits Baskets was originally serialized in Japan starting in 1998, and it didn't finish until 2006. The anime was in 2001, so you know it definitely did not cover the entire manga, unfortunately. I know a lot of fans who love the Fruits Baskets anime, who love the Fruits Baskets manga. I unfortunately still haven't watched or read it. I really should. I've heard so many awesome things about it, and Yen Press released such great and beautiful editions of Fruits Baskets. They did like omnibus volumes of Fruits Baskets, and they look so amazing, and I gotta read it. Honestly, I know a lot of fans have been waiting for this so many years. We're talking about 17 years, and you're finally gonna be getting a reboot of the Fruits Baskets anime that's going to be covering the entire series from beginning to end. And this announcement was actually found on one of the manga releases that's been happening in one of the manga magazines that's been serialized in. And it said Zenpen. And Zenpen in Japanese means like the whole story, the complete story. So it's actually going to be getting an anime reboot covering the entire manga. I know a lot of people are like freaking out over this because it's a big deal. Fruits Baskets fans, they really love this series. I know a lot of people cherish this series. A lot of people actually got into anime because of Fruits Baskets. So I'm just really excited to see where this reboot goes, and I'll definitely check it out this time around because, like I said, I've never read or watched Fruits Baskets, and I'm really curious to see what it's going to be like, and a reboot is going to look beautiful, so can't wait. Another story that's actually going to be getting another anime, well, not another anime, but a third season, turns out to be Chihaya Furu. I don't know how many of you have watched Chihaya Furu, but I cannot recommend it enough. It is absolutely amazing, and the way that I think of it, honestly, is as this meme. So the this one right here, I actually made my own version of this meme after watching season one of Chihaya Furu. Just take a look at this. Isn't it true though? Am I wrong? Honestly, that's all I thought about during the first season of Chihaya Furu. I haven't gotten to season two yet because season one just took so much out of me. It was like, I was an emotional wreck. I was like, please! So I haven't exactly watched season two yet, but I will definitely catch up before season three starts. It's actually going to be starting in April, and there was actually just a like new visual released by Madhouse. So take a look at this. I love the red. I love seeing our three main characters. I know it's going to be so emotional and I cannot wait. It's kind of like a sports anime, technically, but the best way that I could describe how I feel when I want to recommend Chihaya Furu is through ProZD's video. So if you haven't watched ProZD's video on Chihaya Furu, definitely go watch that because same way I feel when trying to recommend Chihaya Furu to someone because it's so great, but people are like, huh? Really? Like, Go watch it if you haven't already. It's getting a third season very, very soon. Next up, it turns out that Attack on Titan will actually be entering its last and final arc. I know a lot of people have been keeping up with it. I mean, Attack on Titan has always been such a huge series. Maybe not as huge as it was when it first started, but I know there are still so many fans of Attack on Titan. Recently, it was just announced that Attack on Titan will be entering its last and final arc. If you would like to read it, it's definitely being cyberpublished on Crunchyroll, so you can read that as it's being released in Japan. It's been a great series, and I know Isayama has been announcing since 2014. He's like, 3 more years of this manga, that's it. And it's been 1 year more, so we got one extra year of Attack on Titan, and probably maybe 2 extra years because it's probably not going to end towards, you know, maybe mid-2019. So we still got some more extra time out of the Attack on Titan manga, but this is what Isayama planned. He was planning for it to end in 3 to 4 years, and the time is definitely, it's catching up. So I don't know how many of you are up to date with the Attack on Titan manga. I know I'm definitely not up to date. It's just bad on my part because I started reading so many other things. I just didn't have the time to, but I really want to get back into the manga. And if you've been reading it, just be prepared. It's entering that final arc. It's going to be ending soon. But all good stories, all great stories come to an end, right? So it's sad to see it go, but I would love to see how the story just concludes because it's going to be epic, I'm pretty sure. It has to be. It's Attack on Titan. Next up, it turns out that another manga actually has an important announcement. We don't really know what this important announcement is, but Dr. Stone actually has an important announcement to make on November 19th. So with the 51st issue of this manga, they're actually going to be making an important announcement. We don't really know what it is, but one can hope that it's an anime announcement. Honestly, Dr. Stone deserves an anime. As soon as I started reading Dr. Stone, I was like, this needs to be turned into an anime. As I was reading it, I was like, this would make a perfect anime. So I'm hoping that they are going to be announcing an anime adaptation, not a pachinko machine. So we'll have to see how that goes on November 19th, but I'm looking forward to it. manga is by Riichiro Inagaki and Boichi, and you can actually read it in Viz's Shonen Jump. Last but not least, it turns out that The Promised Neverland actually just got an updated trailer for its anime. This anime is going to be airing in January 2019. Rumor is that it's going to be on Amazon Prime, so that's frustrating. The thing is that once it's on Amazon Prime, a lot of the viewership goes down because a lot of people don't have Amazon Prime. I know that happened for like Made in Abyss. It also happened for like Land of the Lustrous. So luckily, those titles did end up going to High Dive, but I know a lot of people were like, go watch it, because it just didn't reach everyone, and those series were so good, and yeah, that's what happened with Amazon Prime. So the rumor is, from what I've heard, that it's going to be on Amazon, but The Promised Neverland is a great story. It's going to be adapted by A1 Pictures' CloverWorks. So CloverWorks has worked on the Persona 5 anime, and I forgot what else. But I hope that it turns out to be a really awesome anime, because the manga is so emotional. It's so intense and under pressure. It's really, really awesome. And I think the visuals so far look great. The visuals look great. And the trailer that they released isn't really a trailer, because it didn't really show anything at all. Like, what kind of trailer is that? So I kind of worried in that sense, because I would like to see more material, especially since January 2019 is coming up. So hopefully by December something, we'll get another actual like trailer. But I hope it turns out to be a great anime adaptation. If you haven't read the manga already, it's by Kosuke Demizu. It's a great manga. You can read it in Viz's Shonen Jump as well. So we'll have to see how that goes, but I am definitely pretty hopeful towards it. Anyway, thank you guys so much for watching this week's anime news. If you have anything to comment regarding to any of the topics that I discussed today, feel free to comment below. Thank you guys once again for watching. Please like, share, or subscribe if you like this video, and I will see you guys next time.